announce your second fight of the night. Let's introduce our fighters. Ladies and gentlemen, he fights in the red corner. His club is Manchester, ground and pound. Let's give a big, big Manchester round of applause, Sean Teasdale.
What an excellent support here we've got tonight for Sean Teasdale. Our second fight of the evening, Sean Teasdale from Manchester Ground and Pound. Cornered there, you can see Manchester Ground and Pound's coaches. We've got Daddy Rogerson, Ozzy Haloop. Both very experienced fighters in their own right.
Sean Teasdale, he's only 17 years old, but he's quite an accomplished grappler already. He's been on the grappling circuit, he's won a couple of competitions. I've heard good things about this young lad from people that know what they're talking about. He's supposed to be quite good on the floor, he's always one to watch. You know, he's taking a fight at 17 years old, stepping in the cage. It's not an easy thing to do, but he's a very confident young man, and I'm quite looking forward to seeing what he's doing.
He certainly looks a very mature 17 years old in his body. He's looks strong, came in nice and away. He's got some great guys behind him, like Daddy Rogerson and Ozzy Haloop. Very experienced grapplers and MMA fighters. I mean, Ozzy Haloop especially has fought for titles. I trained with him back in 2003, and he's already an experienced and accomplished grappler and MMA fighter.
And his opponent tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Sam Bolt.
Okay, the second fighter for our second bout, Sam Bolt. Sam's an independent fighter, so he's trains at different gyms, but he's independently managed. He's got a record of one fight and one loss. Do you know much about him, John? It's Cornerman there wearing the Gracie Baja top, so I imagine him to have some groundwork. We've all pulled those sort of chicks ourselves as well.
In the blue corner, from the Manchester Ground and Pound Club, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up, Sean Teasdale! And his opponent tonight fights in the red corner. Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause, Sam! This is a semi-pro fight over 3 5-minute rounds.
Okay, so we get some last-minute instructions here from our referee for this bout, Mr. Trevor Mitchell, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu brown belt from the Dungeon Gym up in Sunderland. A very experienced referee and martial artist in his own right. As the cage door gets locked,
standing.
They're very quickly into a clinch there. A couple of kicks there from Sean, but he wasn't really interested, and we've got a clinch. Sean looks to have quite a tight clinch there, and he's looking to get probably to get top position on a takedown. Still really jockeying for a position there. Once when they both got an under over, it's a fairly neutral clinch. But Sean has got his hands gripped, so maybe that'll give him that slight advantage. But at the moment, it's fairly neutral.
Sam, of course, enjoys the advantage. At least he's got Sean pressed into the cage.
That's right. While they're jockeying for position, it's definitely a benefit to get the opponents back to the cage because they can't sprawl. And there you see how he used that. You've got to take the legs out there without being able to sprawl. And here we have Sean on top.
Well, this isn't the best of the position for Sean to be in.
Certainly. I mean, what we look at with MMA, they've now moved into half guard. Half guard is definitely a better position, especially when you're on top. However, in semi-pro rules, you haven't got the strikes to the head, so it needs to be getting past the guard to start working those submissions. There's not very much you can do from half guard position.
You see the referee clapping there, telling him to get active. What you find with the semi-professional rules is, if it's not quite an active jiu-jitsu fight on the floor, the referees will stand them up quite quickly.
Yeah, certainly. It's, I mean, the crowd are here to watch a fight. And it's when it gets stalled, especially semi-pro, because there aren't the headshots, it can stall quite easily. So the referee will be standing up very quick in this bout. Makes it, telling them as soon as it starts stall in this position, it starts to stall. Referee was saying, come on, keep moving. Try to better your position.
Getting them stood back up.
Now, that's definitely well advised. Moving away from the cage.
Your opponent can use that to reverse the position.
Sean's doing there, trying to better his position.
Now, that is again different to the professional rules, where you might see the guys later trying to stack them against the cage so they can work those head strikes.
And here we look at him trying to go to a high mount position. Sean here definitely looking for a submission. And a better position from there would be not underneath mount. As I got both fighters confused.
It's because the name sounds so similar. Because they rhyme.
So here we go. So here we have Sam looking for a tie mount. He's looking to work that S mount position. He's got the arms in there. Sean's keeping the arm in place, but he's trying to move himself around. Maybe looking for a triangle, or possibly just for the armbar.
As he's climbing up to this high position now, what sort of options does that give you? Why is that better than sitting back on his opponent's hips?
If the opponent's putting their arms up and you can get up tight like that, nice and tight, you can work around keeping his head off the floor so that he can't bridge. And as he moves down to that tight position, he can be looking for either an armbar, or if he slides his arm through to try and do a backdoor escape, he can work the triangle. But he can keep a nice, with that S mount where he's got the leg underneath, he can keep balance. And there he has lined up the triangle. Now, I would prefer to get the triangle a little bit tighter before I roll to my back. However, he's got it there. He needs to pull his shin down to try and lock that underneath the knee. Maybe get his legs out to the side. That's why it would have been easier to tighten this up before he rolled over. However, he has done. Maybe look at him to try and grab. He's tightened it up now. As he's bent over there, he's tightened it up himself. There he goes, and he's tapped. That's a nice win for the independent fighter, and I think maybe that Gracie Barha t-shirt was not a blag. We'll call him the Ronin. We'll hand over to our MC and our beautiful interviewer, Mr. Chris Bacon.